I mean, at least the advantage here is everything I make is straight profit. I'm not paying for liquid fertilizer for these last two fields. Sure, what the next thing we need to do is we'll get these contracts polished off, obviously. But I think we're then pretty much done for March, except selling the consumables. So we'll sell the tomatoes and the butter, and then we'll be on to April. I think the big thing here is we're going to be looking at what's up for store sales. We do need a seeder. We need a baler wrapper. Although, not in a big hurry unless we get a contract that requires wrapped grass. That's when we will need the baler wrapper. But for everything else we've got, the small Deutz is really adequate for what we're doing. It's a low horsepower need and has is capable of producing the largest standard round bales. So I don't have a concern with not having, with keeping it. Oh. She's still struggling. Oh. Anyway, this is good for the land and good for our bank balance somewhat. But yeah, if we don't come up with a seeder before the end of March, I am going to have to buy one at full price. But as I said, the butter's giving us about 40,000 income. So that might be what we use to buy a planter, seeder. We need sorghum planted. And then we figure out the next thing. And once the sorghum's planted, it's just the cows and the sell the consumables until our fields start growing. Oh, come on, keep going. Sure, I'm going to make it to the bottom here. But yeah, if it rains today, I'm not going to be able to do any sawing. I can screw stuff to set together in the basement, but Mrs. Osa would prefer I don't make a big giant mess in there and throw up dust. Oops. $256 left. We'll race up to the top here. See if I can get some of these. 83. Ooh, and not enough. Okay then. Have a check, see how we did. Contracts, that's down there. We are 90% done. We are definitely... Was that? That was the second load, so that's 70,000. Oh, I want to know. I wanted to wait. Not sure how many places we've just lost trees. I think where there are vast acreages of edge along the side of a field, there probably used to be trees there, which are gone now. Still, it does make easier driving at altitude because there aren't as many trees along the side of the road. I don't know if there used to be trees along here behind our sheds, because there's one or two there, but there's no more. And I did chop down about five hedges along that stone wall. Well, normally Cavalier Roy does not bury walls in hedges, so we may have ended up with some trees being swapped out for hedges. Okay, and there we go for the third time. How big are these fields? Details. Doesn't it say? Oh, 8.795 acres. So they're about the same size. That's fine. Is there something I wanted to do here? Because I think there were trees along this cow pig plot as well that just aren't there. Okay, take it easy here because we need to wait. Oh. And go. I also want to buy... I got to look up where my canola's growing. Because I also wanted to buy a couple of beehives for the canola fields that we have. Just so we get a little boost in production and a little bit more honey. Honey's not great. I think the pallets are only about 400 litres. Now, our pallet holding area will hold 4 pallets double stacked, so 8 pallets total, which is fine. And I don't ship them out very often. It's really more a case of, oh, I got nothing better to do. Oh, let's just take some honey to the store because I could use with a little bit of more cash. Anyway, so 90% done. I think I will do the let's just drive through the hedge gaps to get to the field we need to fertilize next. Okay. Is it the field in front of you? Yeah, the field directly in front of us between the gaps in the hedge where the hedges have magically vanished. Okay. Turn that off. Let's get this thing up the hill. When even fully laden, this tractor does not like the weight of this manure truck. However, if I turn it on, we would not be moving at all. So, we'll do the old-fashioned way and go. And the contract is finished. Good. Let's drive through the hedge. Do the next one. This is probably some of the worst fields to work on this map. How are we doing driving? Cannot sustain. So, it looks like I'm driving up the field and then coming back with the spreader on. It is what it is. Or I could change it to go north-south. Well, there's a thought. Control-S, set A, set cardinal back. So, it is what it is. We will spread this field laterally. And one of the reasons I didn't swap the 8R out for the Magnum. Magnum has a little less horsepower. I mean, not enough to write home about. You're talking within 10 horsepower, I think. It has the tracks, and I wasn't sure if the tracks would make a difference with the ability to haul this truck. It's the only thing I've got that this tractor does not do well with. But still, it is what it is. We're definitely doing better going laterally, so that's good. And then, oh, we'll manure the trees as well. Why not? struggling. But come on, you can do it. Yay. I think what we'll end up doing is probably going all the way to the top end of this field and then starting at the top and working our way down. Okay, we need a weight. Let's go get one. It's entirely possible that a weight might make a difference, because it'll put the front wheels firmer on the ground, which may help with traction. I don't think traction is our problem. I think power is our problem. And the one of the ways to tell that is when you've slowed down, look at the tractor from the side and see if the wheels are slipping or whether you're just not going anywhere. Okay. So I don't think anything new will have come in. Nope. Weights. That's super pricey. I'm thinking that's a 2500, 2.5 tons. That's just too costly. I mean, I'm guessing I can not use that. That's 5,000 for 1,700. That's, oh, let's go 2.5. It's 3,700. And we will buy one of those. And, oh, come in from the other side, okay. Come on. Thank you. Alrighty. So now I've got a huge weight on the front. I can ram that car out of the way. No. It should make the tractor a little more stable. Obviously, with more weight, it might make things, might make going up hills fully loaded a little bit more of a struggle, because we're 2.5 tons heavier than we were, if traction wasn't the problem. I mean, I'm not doing too badly. We're running maximum speed here. But I shouldn't lose steering. Oh. Suppose I could get paid for the contract we finished. I'll be interesting to see two things. Coming out of the farm, do the front wheels stay on the ground and just keep steering positive? And then does climbing up past the dairy slow things down? I'm hoping with the production increases that income on the farm will be significantly higher. I mean, at the moment, well, I do make some money in the winter selling the totally excess flour, but since we're going to need about 450,000 litres of flour to run the bakery for 12 months, I don't think I'm going to have a lot of flour left over to sell. But we are, I think, going to have a lot of butter. Just because of the milk production. I mean, we've been running about an hour. And 15,000, so I'm not too big at the moment. Contracts, yes. That one is completed, let's get paid. And this one's only worth, oh, this one will pay out 5,000. It's worth 2,000 after you factor in the cost of fertilizer. Our fertilizer doesn't cost anything, so we'll take home 5,000 from this. And that thing is not even. I mean, we've taken out, this is, what was it, 140,000 now? Gone from that thing. And yes, okay, steering much more stable. Let's see how the hill climb is. Definitely making, we're up to full speed on the flat. That's not bad. I'm not losing as much speed. I think the lack of traction on the front was an issue here. I mean, obviously we're down to 30, but we're not down to 15. Still coping, climbing. Okay, so definitely having a very, very heavy front weight on the front of this 8R has made a dramatic difference to our haulage ability. The next question is, I think when we enter the field, I'm gonna run up the side of the field with the thing turned on and see if we have any issues. This weight may have been all I needed to completely transform this tractor. And maybe we should pay more attention to weights. It's not something I've paid much attention to. I've known in the past if you put a weight on the front of a tractor, it helps the front wheels grip. And, you know, less issues with turning. Or controlling a turn, should I say. Okay. Let's jump out here and open the back and go. Now we are going uphill. We are losing speed. Yeah, okay. I will say that running this piece of equipment while hauling uphill is not something this tractor can do comfortably. We're now at the top, so but we're definitely capable of keeping our speed up on the flat. Turn off, thank you. Grief. So the YEI was suggesting you look for wheel slippages. You come alongside and look at the rotation of the tractor tyres versus the movement speed. And if the tyres are slipping, then you have a traction issue. You should put wheel weights, front weights. Just do what you can to improve the amount of weight on the tyres. Now, as we're seeing there, it's easier to see if it's manifesting by watching the rear tyres. Front tyres, not so much. And there's also a question of, well, if I've got a two-wheel drive tractor, so I need the rear wheels drive. Do I need much weight on the front unless I'm turning? You do better with wider tyres on the back, more tyres on the back, a weight on the back, or something like that. But, I mean, okay, as I said, it's not able to pull uphill, but we have transformed its general operating capacity. So I'm kind of happy with that. We are most definitely moving this. This load. Anyway, run across here and off. All righty. So just a couple of bits down here, and we are more than done. Not sure, well, 8,000 might be enough.